Now I am become death, the destroyer of worlds. I suppose we all thought that, one way or another.
On September 1st, 1939, Poland gets invaded by Nazi Germany, which marks the beginning of the Second World War. As the threat of the Axis powers grew larger and larger, the Allies needed a weapon that was strong enough to stop them for good. Shortly before the beginning of the Second World War, in 1938, Austrian physicist Lise Meitner and German chemist Otto Hahn discovered nuclear fission. Fission is a nuclear reaction in which the nucleus of an atom splits into two or more smaller and lighter nuclei. Fission produces gamma photons and releases very large quantities of energy. For example, uranium-235 plus a neutron will become uranium-236, which will then split into barium-141, krypton-92, and 3 neutrons. After this discovery, there were talks that this type of energy could be harnessed and used for weapons. This became an obvious fear for the Allies. They believed that the Germans would develop an atomic weapon first, especially since most of the leading scientists at the time were from Europe. Hungarian-American physicist Leo Szilard demonstrated his concerns with German-born physicist Albert Einstein in a letter to President Franklin Delano Roosevelt. On August 2, 1939, the president received the Einstein-Szilard letter, which can be found in the description below, but to summarize, the letter states, "It may become possible to set up a nuclear chain reaction in a large mass of uranium by which vast amounts of power and large quantities of new radium-like elements would be generated. Now it appears almost certain that this could be achieved in the immediate future. This new phenomenon would also lead to the construction of bombs, and it is conceivable, though much less certain, that extremely powerful bombs of a new type may thus be constructed. A single bomb of this type, carried by boat and exploded in a port, might very well destroy the whole port together with some of the surrounding territory." After Roosevelt read this letter, he immediately took action and started what would be known as the Manhattan Project. The president called American engineer and physicist Lyman Briggs of the National Bureau of Standards to head the Advisory Committee on Uranium in order to investigate the claims stated by the letter. The committee reported to the president in November that uranium would provide a possible source of bombs with a destructiveness vastly greater than anything now known. Los Alamos, New Mexico. A remote and secret laboratory was opened in 1943 by the University of California and was directed by the American theoretical physicist and professor of physics at UC Berkeley, J. Robert Oppenheimer. The laboratory was organized into 5 divisions: administration, theoretical, experimental physics, chemistry and metallurgy, and ordnance and engineering. The administration's goals at the beginning were to define a program definition and divide up responsibilities. The administration also dealt with community affairs, housing, security, salary policies, and draft deferment. The theoretical division was headed under Hans Bethe, and its goals were to develop nuclear and hydrodynamical criteria for the design of the atomic bomb and to predict its detailed performance as well as analyze the explosion, develop associated calculation techniques, and give increasingly reliable and accurate nuclear specifications for the bomb as new physical data became available. The experimental division was headed under Robert Bakker, and its goals were to perform detailed or differential experiments and attempt to observe the effects of isolate nuclear phenomena. The chemistry and metallurgy division was headed under Joseph W. Kennedy, and its goals were to conduct research on uranium, also the purification and fabrication of active tamper and initiator materials for the bombs, and several service activities for the rest of the laboratory. The Ordnance and Engineering Division was headed under Captain W.S. Deke Parsons, and its goals were to find a way to assemble several critical masses of material fast enough to produce a successful high-order explosion. Incorporation of active material, tamper, and assembly mechanisms into a practical airborne bomb. After ongoing research and development at the Los Alamos Laboratory, the gadget was created. Assembly began on July 13, 1945. First, the polonium-beryllium urchin initiator was assembled. The function of the urchin is to kickstart the chain reaction at the optimal moment by producing a burst of neutrons upon activation. After assembly, Lewis Slodin placed the urchin inside two hemispheres of a plutonium-239 core. Cyril Smith placed the core in the uranium-238 tamper plug. The gaps of air were filled with 0.5 mil gold foil, and the halves of the plug were held together with uranium washers and screws. The gadget was then driven and hoisted to the top of the 100-foot steel tower. The detonation of the gadget was initially planned for 4 mountain wartime, but was postponed because of rain and lightning. Scientists feared that this weather would increase the fallout via rain, and the lightning could prematurely detonate the bomb. July 16, 1945, at 5:29:21 Mountain Wartime, the gadget exploded with an energy equivalent to around 22 kilotons of TNT. The explosion created a crater approximately 4.7 feet deep and 88 yards wide. The mushroom cloud reached 7.5 miles in height. The explosion was felt over 100 miles away. The immense amount of heat caused the desert sand to melt, and it became a mildly radioactive glass that was light green in color, named trinitite. The energy is distributed roughly as 50% blast, 35% thermal radiation, which is made up of a wide range of the electromagnetic spectrum, including infrared, visible, and ultraviolet light, and some soft X-rays emitted at the time of the explosion. 5% as initial ionizing radiation, consisting chiefly of neutrons and gamma rays emitted within the first minute after detonation, and 10% as residual nuclear radiation, which is the hazard in fallout. The little boy was 120 inches in length, 28 inches in diameter, and weighed approximately 9,700 pounds. The bomb contained a total of 141 pounds of uranium. Less than a kilogram of uranium underwent fission. Only 0.6 grams was transferred into several forms of energy, mostly kinetic, but also heat and radiation. The little boy can be simplified down to 13 components. 1. The stabilizing fins, which are used in flight, making it possible to aim them with a higher degree of accuracy. 2. The tail cone, which is used as a sort of exhaust pipe. 3. The air inlet tubes, which are used to allow air to reach the inside parts for cooling. 4. The air pressure detonator, which is activated when at a specific atmospheric pressure, which initiates the reaction. 5. The lead shield container, which is used to block radiation. Lead has a high molecular density and can block gamma and X-rays. 6 and 7. The detonation arm and head can be described simply as a type of fuse, which is a device that detonates a munitions explosive materials under specified conditions. 8. The conventional explosion charge is made of cordite, which is a smokeless explosive made from nitrocellulose, nitroglycerin, and petroleum jelly, often used in ammunition. 9. The uranium-235 bullet is the projectile that will be shot into the target. 10. The gun cylinder is used to guide the bullet to the target. 11. The uranium-235 target is the site where the uranium bullet will collide and ensure that the two subcritical masses, once fired together, cannot come apart until they explode. 12. The Archie radar altimeter antenna, which was used to determine the altitude attained. 13. The fuses, which were designed to be used at the most destructive altitude, which would then cause the explosion. On August 6, 1945, at approximately 8:15 Japanese Standard Time, the little boy was dropped. After falling for 44.4 seconds, the timer and barometer were triggered, starting the firing mechanism, and then the bomb was detonated. President Harry S. Truman announced the official blast yield to be 20 kilotons of TNT. 66,000 people were killed as a direct result of the Hiroshima blast, and 69,000 were injured to varying degrees. The fat man was 128 inches in length, 60 inches in diameter, and weighed approximately 10,300 pounds. The bomb contained a total of 14.1 pounds of plutonium. The fat man can be simplified down to 9 components. 1. The AN-219 contact fuses, which is the device that detonates a munitions explosive material under specified conditions. 2. The Archie radar antenna, which was used to determine the altitude attained. 3. A plate with batteries, which was used to detonate the charge surrounding the nuclear components. 4. The X unit, which was a firing set placed near the charge. A firing set is a device whose purpose is to remain in an inactive state and initiate detonators in a safe and reliable manner only when intended. 5. The hinge, which fixed the two ellipsoidal parts of the bomb together. 6. The physics package, also known as the Y1561 implosion sphere, was the core of the bomb and had a multitude of intricate components that can be seen here, including charges, initiators, but most importantly, the uranium-238 and plutonium-239 pit. 7. The plate with instruments including radars, baroswitches, and timers. 8. The barotube manifold, which was used to evenly distribute the air to each intake port. 9. The California parachute tail, which was a cubical tail box with 8 fins within the sheet metal box frame, 45 degrees apart from each other, and was used to eliminate any wobble. On August 7, 1945, the day after the bombing of Hiroshima, at approximately 11:02 Japanese Standard Time, the Fat Man was dropped. Following a 43-second free fall at an altitude of about 1,650 feet, the bomb detonated. The official blast yield was 21 kilotons of TNT. Because of the weather, there was poor visibility, and the bomb missed its intended detonation point by almost 2 miles. Despite this, an estimated 35 to 40,000 people were killed by the bombing, and a total of 60 to 80,000 fatalities resulted, including from long-term health effects such as leukemia, burn injuries, and radiation sickness. The Second World War ended on August 15, 1945, when Japan surrendered to the Allied powers. In the immediate post-war years, the Manhattan Project conducted weapons testing at Bikini Atoll as a part of Operation Crossroads. There were developments of new weapons, promotion of the network of national laboratories, supporting of medical research into radiology, and laid the foundation for the nuclear sector of the United States Navy. The Manhattan Project maintained control over American atomic weapons research and production until the formation of the United States Atomic Energy Commission in January 1947. The Treaty of the Non-Proliferation of Nuclear Weapons is an international treaty that went into effect on March 5, 1970. The treaty's central bargain is, the NPT non-nuclear weapon states agree never to acquire nuclear weapons, and the NPT nuclear weapon states in exchange agree to share the benefits of peaceful nuclear technology and to pursue nuclear disarmament aimed at the ultimate elimination of their nuclear arsenals. As of August 2016, 191 states have signed the treaty, including the 5 nuclear weapon states, which are China, France, Russia, the United Kingdom, and the United States. Non-signatories include India, Israel, Pakistan, and South Sudan. North Korea signed the treaty in 1985, but withdrew from the NPT in 2003.